as a general rule, with Everclear, do not ever drink this stuff straight. You just...
You know, I tried to tell that to my friend, but he will drink the whole bottle.
I have friends that drink the other stuff, the Spiritus, which is like the 194.
Oh, yeah. That's a...
Shadowcat. Yeah, Shadowcat drinks
that.
Shadow like from
that.
He just carries a bottle of it around the con. I don't know how he does it. He does it in fursuit, too.
Shadow's a very special exception.
Yeah, he's definitely special.
It sounds like Infinity Fun special, yeah.
Just a little bit.
Just a little bit.
So what are you starting off with tonight?
I think tonight I'm going to start off with my usual classic. I am going to make one named after, do any of you guys know X the Fox?
Yes.
I've heard the name.
Alright, I named this drink after him.
He's in our chat, dude.
And I believe he's actually here, I just don't know why he's not in here. Because usually he's all over this kind of stuff. Mm. Spencer sent me a drink after him. This drink is called an Angry Blue Fox. It is made with pineapple rum, Mountain Dew Voltage, Faygo Cream Soda, a little bit of sweet and sour, and my personal favorite, a little bit of this sour stuff here.
I love the green apple.
This is like the best. There's only a couple liquor stores in my area that carry it. Like, I can't get this at Meijer anymore for some reason. But I have like four bottles of this at home. I go through it all the time. You can add this to like any fruity drink and it just makes it a million times better.
You can completely drink it straight and it's absolutely beautiful. And you will
I drink this shot straight.
So TFF.
Yeah, it's like one of those hangovers you get, like where you get drunk one night, you sleep for 6 hours, and then you wake up the next morning and you're still drunk.
Just a little bit.
I did that last year. It was fun.
I did that last year because of mistake.
Unfortunately, the night that I did that last year was the night that we had the fire drill at 6 in the morning.
Yep.
That was nothing.
So,
what is the number one cardinal rule of making good professional drinks?
Know your portions.
Know your portions, but there's another one.
Measure properly.
Ice.
What about your ice?
We got it right here. That's all you need, right?
Yeah, but what are you supposed to do with the ice?
If you want to do it professionally, normally you use a cocktail shaker. I don't use it for this because I cheat.
So, in a professional sense, whenever you're wanting to make cocktails, the reason that a lot of times, especially at cons, because we're furries, we love to get drunk, we never use ice proportions. Whenever you're making drinks professionally, you always fill your glass with ice. It's really not the bartenders trying to cheat you out of your liquor. It's every drink that the proportions are made, that is what they're based off of. Now, obviously, tonight we're making like our own concoction, so that all kind of depends. But when you do make... Exactly. But when you do make drinks professionally, you are supposed to use a full glass of ice.
Yes, because if I remember correctly, you actually used to be a bartender.
I still am. I have my liquor license at home. I don't have it on me this year.
We're supposed to bring it so we can legally serve people in here.
I'm not paying the fee to the banquet fee. I don't have the $3,000 on me to pay.
Good.
No, thank you.
So yeah, we'll wait till after the official panel if you guys want to taste stuff.
Can we sniff whatever you mix, can we sniff whatever you mix, though?
Yes, you can sniff it. You just can't drink it.
Everyone is 21, right?
Yeah,
I told them a few minutes ago we were supposed to have doors by outside carding people, and they never showed up.
We already telegrammed the lead, but he's been offline for 2 hours.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Well, just as long as everyone's over 21.
Yeah.
Under? Allegedly.
Over.
Yeah, because I was telling them that I saw like an entire gaggle of kids that could not have been older than 10 about 5 minutes ago.
Ooh.
I'm like,
that does not need to know.
I'm like, why are there kids under 10 at a furry convention?
Why not? No. Were they with their parents? That's the better question.
I don't know if they were their parents. They didn't look much older than they were.
Yeah, you never know.
Older siblings, I guess.
Okay.
So, drink. Anyway, Angry Blue Fox. First, we're going to start out with our ice. Just because I'm using my ridiculous glass here. The thing I like about this is it holds all the ice in the top, and when you pour the drinks in, it actually cools them down as it goes down the tube. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Same thing goes with, like, if you're... Just mixing a solo cup. You always use your ice first. One, because it's not going to splash anything. Two, it's going to cool down whatever you put in there. Especially if you have things like, you know, warm soda that tastes like shit when it's warm. Because who's ever drank hot Sprite out of their car?
Oh.
Yes, you know what I'm talking about.
Yeah.
You drink it and just taste the pine salt. Yeah, don't do that.
No, it tastes like gin.
No.
Yeah.
I can go one worse.
Like
hot, flat Sprite.
Hot, flat Sprite. It's like a bad mojito. A really bad mojito. All right, so we are going to start out with our pineapple rum here. I love the smell of that stuff. You can drink this straight, too.
Oh, yeah.
I don't recommend it, but it goes down really easy. And
you can just give me a bottle.
Yeah, this holds about 40 ounces, so I'm attempting to be proportional. It's really hard when you don't use a standard solo cup size.
Where did you get that thing?
I bought this from England, and they don't even sell them in the States. I had to pay like $150 for it, plus importing it and praying that it didn't get destroyed in the mail.
Yeah. You said 40 ounces?
About 40 ounces. 2.5 imperial pints, so roughly 40 ounces.
Okay.
And somebody can skull one of those in 11 seconds.
I think the record is actually, it used to be held by the former Australian Prime Minister at 6 seconds. I honestly don't know how somebody chugs beer that fast without getting it all.
Gotta train.
So,
okay, we don't know if it's cream soda. That one's kind of going up.
Kind of fizzy.
So while I'm working on this, what you got in mind for your first drink? You look like you could use some alcohol.
Okay, so all of you may judge me here. How many of you have ever had hard seltzer? Oh, thank you. At least someone in here has. So, believe it or not, I'm going to drink tonight, but I'm actually on a diet right now. I don't know if y'all have heard of the keto diet, but I found these wonderful things, the hard seltzers that you can buy at the store. They've got them from all different brands. These things are absolutely wonderful. It's like flavored fizzy water that gets you drunk really quick.
Yeah, so next we got our sweet and sour.
I'm surprised there's no blue curacao in that.
Usually I don't throw it in there. Just because, you know, I actually like the flavor of the Mountain Dew better. And you don't really want to go like way too much orange citrus with that. It just kind of overpowers it.
Yeah.
Is it also 40 ounces with those two?
Like, as in, like, the bottles?
No, I meant, like, how much you put in.
Well, like I said, this is special because it's a weird size. I'm just mixing this to proportion, but usually I try to do, like, in a standard solo cup, usually I do, you know, standard shot size of pineapple rum, and I try to do the majority, my two soda flavors, and then I kind of top it off with a little bit of each of these. I always add this last because, you know, you get your color, you drink it, and the dark stuff just kind of glistens down the drink. It makes...
You've already added that one.
Yeah, I need to add I don't know how much I got in there. Yeah, I need to throw my this in here if it's not exploding.
So, fun fact while he's finishing his drink, does anyone know how, in mixology, how you get the different, like, color patterns in drinks?
It involves the density of the liquid, right?
Correct.
Yes. Serum. Different alcohols and different sugar contents will actually float differently. So, such as with a Long Island, there's time, if you look at the pictures of the Long Island, you'll notice how there's always a dark spot in the Long Island, and then you got the rest of the Long Island, which is almost like a kind of a very tint yellowish color. That's because the Coke is actually a heavier substance, and it tends to either float or sink and go to one of the two, either the top or the bottom of the drink. So if you ever get a Long Island that is brown all the way through, they used entirely too much Coke.
You know you want some.
Oh, I love that stuff.
And watch, because this stuff is a different density than all the rest of this. You'll see that it kind of floats on the top for a second and then just kind of slowly works its way down. So that'll be like a lime green for a little bit, and then eventually it'll start kind of trickling down through the white and into the blue.
Which I bet you'd be like, it looks like it would react to it.
And I'm sure that if we added some of this, it would kind of do the same thing. It would sit on top and like kind of go weird and crazy for a bit and then kind of filter through. Mm-hmm.
It's like if you add things like Bailey's or things to other alcohol, you'll notice that it kind of like does a curdling effect because Bailey's is a cream base. So
I wish we had, like, I tried to find clear shot glasses, but I wanted to show them the alien brain hemorrhage and exactly how to do that.
I was going to say there's, what's the other one?
The cocaine abortion.
No, the concrete mixer.
Oh, yeah.
I can't drink one of those.
Wait, yeah. Did you say cocaine or abortion?
Yes, it's exactly the same as an alien brain hemorrhage, just without the blue curacao. It looks like an aborted fetus. Alkali came up with the name, I don't know why.
By the way, some of the drinks tonight are inspired by Alkali, so blame Alkali.
Yeah, and a couple of
Alkali.
Most of my drinks I actually name after other furs that I know personally. So,
do they like the drinks that they're named after?
Usually they do. One person that I have another drink that I was going to make tonight, but I do not have the ingredients for it. How many of you guys know Terracoon?
Mm-hmm.
All right, so I was going to make one called Terra's Revenge. And unfortunately, I was unable to source a few cans of Surge to go in the drink. So
you should have told me. We're at Burger King. They have it on tap.
They have it on tap now?
Yes.
Yes.
Oh, well.
Why are you not?
Right. It's nice and cold, too. Have some of that.
You go right at it.
It's just good.
So, I'm sure all of you have heard of this next drink.
I'm like a Jolly Rancher.
I'm sure all of you have heard of this next drink, but have you ever heard of the White Girl Spritzer?
I've heard of it.
It sounds familiar.
It literally tastes like a green Jolly Rancher.
So, you've heard of it. What's a White Girl Spritzer?
Jolly Rancher.
Starbucks.
Sorry,
coffee.
Ask me the question again.
So, you've heard of it. Do you know what's in a White Girl Spritzer?
Oh, I have no clue.
So...
God.
One of my personal favorite drinks of all time. Every time I go out to the bar, without fail, I have to get at least one vodka cranberry.
You smell this?
But a White Girl Spritzer.
You can drink this.
You'll take your ice and take your wonderful dog loving vodka. Now, most of the times when you go out and order a vodka cranberry, things like that, it's the vodka, the cranberry thrown together over some ice, and they slide the glass to you and go, Merry Christmas, Happy New Year. But for a White Girl Spritzer, you take your vodka and your cranberry, a little bit of ice, shake it up a little bit, you get a little, as you shake it, the ice starts to slowly break apart and you'll get little ice flakes in there. I am a white girl. Look, I can get the top of it off.
Justin wants to get white girl wasted.
No, he's got his pinky out.
Now, I should have waited. If you look, when it's poured, see how it kind of looks like a weird tint to it?
Huh.
So, it's because all the little ice crystals are now in there. So it almost becomes like this weird, a little, it's like a little more viscous than normal.
It almost looks like it's got a little bit of a, it's almost like a semi-melted Slurpee.
Yes.
Yeah, that's what I thought.
If only I had my blender make some margaritas.
Ooh, I actually got stuff in my room.
You don't need a blender to make margaritas.
You need a blender if you want to make good
margaritas.
No, you do
that
not.
Was close. What did you do with all of these before you brought them here?
They were in my trunk.
Oh my god.
I've heard if you tap the bottom a couple times, it helps. I've never had one explode, so as far as I'm aware, it works.
Either tapping the bottom or tapping the sides.
Yeah, I usually tap the bottom so I got a ring.
So, this is one of those drinks where that whole professional rule actually goes out the window, because your ice has to come in last. So you got your vodka, your cranberry, you've shaken it with the ice, and you take a little bit of Sprite, and you always leave about this much room in the top of your glass.
Okay.
Because what you do is you take ice cubes and one by one drop them in. And it doesn't seem like it would actually do that much, But with the Sprite on top and the little ice flakes that are already floating around, when you drop these in one by one and they plunge in, it actually pushes the carbonation towards the bottom because of the way the ice flakes are.
Shit, that's good. I need to hire you sometime.
I'm surprised I don't actually bartend more of my own parties. I always get someone else to do it because I don't want to do it.
Well, I mean, once you're paid to do it, it's not as fun.
It's true.
Yeah, people don't pay me to bartend. I just show up with my own alcohol and, like, if you want to chip in your own alcohol, great. If not, you know,
you're
I don't want to come to your fucking party.
So
usually, as long as they at least chip in, I'll, you know, bartend for their party, but if you're not going to chip in on some of the cost, then nope, sorry.
So what are you making next?
I really hope
Alkali shows up like last year, otherwise we've got a crap load of stuff to drink.
Well, speaking of Alkali,
I meant T3K is right after this. Just take them over there.
Well,
oh my god, we should just stick a whole bunch of drinks in front of them and go, leave the remainder of our panel.
Well, I was going to say, do you have anybody that would be willing to
help carry him? Because
he's in the middle of the panel right now.
Yeah, open mic.
Could we find somebody that would be willing to take him a drink as a runner?
Me.
I think we should all do
field trip. No, I'll do it.
Field trip.
Just field trip, and everyone hands him a drink.
Well,
Hold on, I need to
clear this through count operations first. All right. I don't want to get in trouble because I don't have a radio on yet.
Maybe not a field trip, but if we have a volunteer that'd be willing to take
him. I will.
Do you know which room he's in? I'm not sure where
his panel is. Secondary events, open mic.
Yeah, just I saw
it. Right, well, knowing Alkali, I know that he likes his classic rum and coke. I do a spin on rum and coke that is actually really, really good. How many of you guys like rum and coke?
I love it.
It's one of my favorites.
Have you ever had black cherry vanilla rum and coke?
Yes. Oh, and it's amazing.
No, don't
yes.
tell me more.
So I think he's tried this before and he loves it. So I'm going to make him a black cherry vanilla rum and coke, and I like to garnish mine with a maraschino cherry. How many of you guys like maraschino cherries?
I ate
one, two,
never had it. I ate an entire bar of them once.
They're like bar candy.
So, just to be clear, there's a difference between maraschino cherries that come in a jar and the ones that you get in a can. Do not get the ones in the can. The ones in the can taste like someone, like, died in the can.
Yeah. Yes. Get the ones where you can actually see the cherries.
Those, but they come in a plastic jar.
Bigger bars, a lot of times they'll come in big plastic jars because you go through them so quickly.
If you go into McDonald's and get a cherry, that brand.
Mm-hmm. Alright, how many of you guys have ever actually tried this black cherry rum?
Oh.
I use this in a whole bunch of stuff.
I've had their coconut rum.
I will go through one of those bottles.
Yeah, this is another one of those things that it tastes like cherry coke. You can drink this stuff straight too.
Fun fact, if you ever want to get on your con chair's good side, this is Kitten's favorite rum.
I remember a couple years ago, I saw somebody else that had, I think it was her. It was at MST3K and they had another bottle. I'm like, wait a minute, did you steal that out of my panel room? Because I'd never seen anybody else that drank this stuff.
Oh no, she, that
and then
Dr.
I'm like, wait a minute,
Pepper,
mine's accounted for. Cool. I'm going to give him a little bit of extra kick.
And I know exactly how I'm going to present this to him, too.
It's the good stuff.
Alright, can you hand me a note card?
Have your friends at the mixer.
Huh?
I'm going to grab
your friends at the mixer.
No, I'm going to do the bow.
I also remember that he does not like ice in his drinks.
No, he does not.
So we are going to let this kind of cool down a little bit after I get the coconut, because this is warm. So we're going to throw this in here. Let it cool down for a few minutes, and then I'm going to strain it out and put it in a cup for him.
So, another fun fact when it comes to mixology.
This stuff is just awesome. It just smells awesome. I can smell that.
Oh, that is good. Does anyone know how to reduce the head on a beer when you're pouring it?
Yeah, this is.
You pour it into the side of the glass.
You pour it into the side of the glass. What if your glass is chilled?
Quite nice.
That I do not know.
Doesn't have to be angled.
It needs to be angled, But anytime that you are pouring a beer into a chilled glass, always take your glass, find a spot up near the top, rub it on your wrist, and pour the beer on that spot. It keeps it from over producing an overhead when you're pouring it in. Otherwise, it just likes to foam up a lot, and then you've just got nothing but a glass of foam and three-fourths of a bottle of beer.
Although, my favorite, this is what I typically drink at the con, is coconut rum, or no, I'm sorry, pineapple rum with coconut juice and orange juice, and it's basically a poor man's Mai Tai. But you can drink them and you can't taste the alcohol, which makes them really dangerous in an FT3K, because you will go through an entire jug like that.
That's why I'm going to go to that panel. I will be entirely too drunk before we leave. I won't make it through the panel. I will sleep in the panel room that evening.
That's how the fire alarm almost got pulled 1 year with Panda.
Oh, yeah.
Was it that one?
Fire alarm! No!
I need this.
Was that the old hotel? That happened?
That was the old hotel, and I think that was the first year we did a mistake.
Yeah, it was because Furries and Frats happened at the same time.
Oh god, I remember that, and we outdrank the frat.
Oh, that chant, yeah. So,
no, Uncle Kage outdrank the frat.
No, Uncle Kage was in there.
He didn't shut up and shoved his bottle of wine and walked off.
Just a walk by drink out.
Alright.
I mean, for just.
No, because I'm in. And I remember.
Do we have that glass this year?
Have what?
Have a wine glass.
Almost 5-bottle glass.
Of course we have it.
I own it.
It's an IFC tradition.
Yes, I own it.
You own that?
Yes. Well, the original one.
Do you?
I bought it like 5 years ago. He put it in the charity auction because they had like a hairline crack in it.
Yeah.
But yeah.
Does he have a new one yet?
Yes.
I think somebody said that he does. I have not seen it.
I see a lot of pictures.
It would not surprise me.
It would not surprise me, but yes, I do own the original one.
Let me know when I can take that over.
Well, we'll wait and make some more drinks first, because we'll take all the drinks over to him.
Yeah, we'll do it all at once and overwhelm him.
So I'm going to give him that. And then, what else are we going to make for him?
So, I think...
Something involving Rumpelmans.
I think I want to make him... Okay. Will anybody get offended if I use the name of a drink? As long as I'm using it as a name of a drink. It's no really bad words, but...
We don't have any millennials here, right?
Oh my god. I'm close
enough.
I'm
just within that window.
Okay, so I'm going to now make you a Hooker's Sunrise.
That's not.
That's not bad.
I thought you said.
Okay, I had someone get offended because I said hooker one time during one of my panels, so I have to make sure.
It's a 21 plus panel. I think we all
know. Hey, you never know. You never know.
I can't help but think of, have you guys seen old movie Cannonball Run?
Yes. Did we do that for mistake?
You remember when they crash this hotel? The hotel has like no idea what the fuck's going on. And this dude comes up and he's like, "Dude, where are the hookers?" And they're like, to the hotel, like, kind of, and I was like, "What?" He's like, "The hookers, man. Where are the hookers?" I freaking love that movie.
Didn't we do
It's got Jackie Chan in it, too.
Oh, did we do that for Mistake 2 years ago?
Hmm?
Did we do that for Mistake, Cannonball Run?
I don't think I've ever done Cannonball Run for...
Yes, we did. We did because I remember because one of the rules was anytime they say the word cannonball, take a drink.
Was that if that was, that might have been during the Indy 500, although I could have sworn we did a different movie for that. I don't remember much of that time anyway. I was like, well, I think both of us were pretty drunk that one. I think that was the first one that we actually started doing.
What are you talking about?
You're bartending.
I am a good child. I do not drink. Okay. So I want to say it this way, but it sounds so horrible. So this hooker is really layered, okay? So
would you
start with a base of orange juice.
Suck all that.
The ice cube has a divot. It literally came back out of the divot.
So we need to file a complaint in the hotel. Why do our ice cubes have dents? We want perfectly polished
ice cubes.
So you actually start with the orange juice as your base. We're going to move on to pineapple rum. It has a good citrus accent that goes along with it.
And pineapple rum goes good with anything. I put it on this yet.
You go from your pineapple rum, Sprite.
Yes.
This is really a drink that goes from mixer to alcohol, mixer to alcohol, and I love it. Because inevitably when you get to the end as you drink it, you actually get kind of a layered flavor.
Nice.
Yeah. I don't know what I was thinking.
Yeah, don't reach for that. We don't need to kill Alkali before MSTGK.
Oh, he'll be fine. So then you've got your shot of vodka on the top. And then what makes it, instead of a sunny, but a sunrise, is you add in just a little bit of your red. Splash more orange juice.
Shoot, you know what I forgot to bring? Grenadine.
He's like, you keep making me all these drinks and making me drink them.
What was it called again? Hooker's what?
It's a hooker's sunrise.
Very interesting. I like that.
And as you drink it, you actually kind of get the different flavors because the mixer sitting in between kind of. They don't keep the alcohol there, but they kind of contain it.
Yeah.
So it filters into the other ones, but it stays right in the middle.
Yeah, this is pretty good.
And if you ever come to one of my parties, you're probably not going to get these drinks because they take too much time to make.
As long as it's not beer in a can.
Beer in a can. If you want beer in a can, just walk out on the liquor store, pick up some Natty Light.
God, at least pick up some hams. You can get a Dirty 30 for $11. That is my college beer of choice when we go to frat parties because it's cheap. I don't pay to go to frat parties. I'm like, here's an $11 case of beer. I'm gonna go drink your tequila. All
right, so my next drink that I'm gonna make. How many of you guys have ever actually heard of a drink that I make called a Yippie Vixen? Okay, nobody. Good. I don't think I made this one last year.
You didn't.
Okay, the Yippie Vixen is a drink I came up with at GasCon 2014, also known as MFF.
Yeah!
And this drink was in that glass, and believe it or not, it saved my butt during the evacuation. I was down on the con floor with that, and a building a Yippie Vixen, and con security comes up and says, hey, can't have that on the con floor. I'm like, okay, I'll take it back up to my room. I walk from the Hyatt back to the Hilton, which was where I was staying. I walk in there, chug the rest of the thing, and get going back downstairs. And all of a sudden, my roommate's pilot said, hey, they're evacuating the hotel across the street. I'm like, what? They're like, yeah. You know, you got out of there just in time. It's like mosh pit down there. I'm like, hooray for having alcohol on the floor. Get me sent back to my room. So I avoided the traffic. Anyway. A Yippie Vixen is named after a friend of mine who actually is a Yippie Vixen. And this is probably one of my favorite drinks. I serve this all the time at parties because it's ridiculously easy to make. The problem is when I'm outside of Michigan or like the Midwest, it's hard because it's not exactly easy to find flavor cream soda in every state. And I've tried millions of different cream sodas that are out there. I've tried the Barks one. I've tried Jones, I've tried all the other ones. They just don't work. You gotta use that. So, a Yippie Vixen is pineapple rum is your starter. And this is one that I usually make like large punch bowls full of it and it disappears in like 5 minutes. People ask, ooh, this is really good. What's in it? I'm like, there's an entire fifth of rum in that punch bowl. I would take it easy if I
So, no kidding. Went out to Walmart today, bought one of those giant, like 3 gallon drink holders that have the little ice thing that you can stick down in it.
Oh yeah, I saw that on your, up on your little table there.
Yep.
I have one of those at home. They're super handy.
Oh, all right. So beautiful.
So I'm gonna grab that, a little bit of Faygo cream soda. Mine doesn't explode. And then I need some orange juice. Which one is open?
That one.
Now, usually for this, I try to mix it, but for individual cups, I usually do like your standard, you know, shot size serving of rum. And then I usually try to mix my orange juice 50-50 with the cream soda, and it tastes exactly like an Orange Julius from Dairy Queen. You can drink these all day long and not realize there's any rum in it until it's too late, and then you get drunk and fall down like Alkaline.
We love Alkaline.
And because there's orange juice in it, you know, you're getting your vitamin C.
You're getting your pineapple.
Alkaline is wonderful. He makes a perfect drink tester.
Oh my God, smell that. You'll enjoy that.
That really does taste, or I haven't even tasted it yet.
Yes.
It has been, I've been up since 5 a.m.
You can use that.
Does it smell like a Yippee Big Thing?
That really tastes like an Orange Julius. And I haven't had one of those in a while.
It does, doesn't it?
Yeah.
Like I said, you can drink all day long.
Alkaline doesn't get this one.
I bet you can't even taste it. Rum.
No, this one's fine.
And there's like 3 shots in there for you.
I'm okay with that. Challenge accepted.
So yeah, I think
Mama didn't raise a quitter.
Yeah, I do that at parties all the time, and usually when I do the large punch bowl size, I do an entire fifth of rum, 1 gallon of orange juice, and a full 2 liter of cream soda. And then when I do it in the punch bowl, I actually prefer to use dry ice because it doesn't water down the drink, which can be a problem depending on what you're making. And the thing with dry ice is because it doesn't, you know, actually contain water, it carbonates your drink as well. So it keeps your carbonated stuff carbonated, and it creates this really awesome orange creamsicle scented fog that intoxicates the whole house. Everybody fucking comes running to the punch bowl, like, what the fuck is that? That is awesome. And then it's like gone in 2 minutes, you gotta make 4 more batches in an hour. And then everybody's cast out on the couch. It's great.
So I don't know how many of all of you like actually hold parties at your house or at cons or things like that. But if you're ever wanting to hold a party and also have a good time without having to worry about constantly mixing drinks for your guests, getting things like drink dispensers and things like that are wonderful.
Oh yeah.
But I've seen way too many people make the mistake of they'll get the ones that don't have the center core where you would put ice. So they throw ice in with the drink, and by the time you get halfway through, the drink dispenser is watered down, tastes gross, is nasty.
Or it's so, overflowing because of when the ice melts.
That too. I've seen that. So always make sure that if you're making large batches of drinks for like a lot of people, either don't include the ice and make sure there's enough ice for them to be able to pour it over ice, or get something that will sit in the center of your drink dispenser that will hold the ice but still chill everything.
Yeah, because I mean, I've seen some people kind of cheat a little bit. They have like those little molds where you can actually make like the big block of ice rings that you just sit on top of the cooler or whatever. I mean, those work okay, but if, like you said, it still waters down your drinks, and if nobody's drinking your stuff, it could possibly overflow, and then you just have a huge mess on your hands. Mm-hmm. That's also why I use dry ice, because when it melts, it just evaporates. You don't have to worry about extra. And it keeps it like super, super cold.
I love dry ice.
It's not easy to get though, it's expensive. It's like, for like a brick of it like this, it's like $25.
And fun fact, in the state of Georgia, you have to be 18 to purchase it.
Well, yeah, because that Mythbusters episode, they were saying about you cut off little chunks of it, you mix it with water, and it explodes in a bottle. We don't recommend that. Don't ever do that.
No, if you're going to do that, use sodium.
Yeah. No.
No. Okay. Disclaimer, because we are being recorded right now. Do not do anything dangerous that is going to explode or catch on fire or set off the fire alarm.
This is also why you don't use this for bar tricks. I've seen the guys at the Reading Fair. They will take a swig of this stuff. They'll do their fire eating thing, and they'll go big ass flames everywhere, and they'll burn down the stage. And being a Hawaiian con, that's funny. Do not try any fire eating in the hotel. They will kick you out.
I actually saw some.
We discourage that.
You need to make the next drink. I'm drinking your drink right now.
You're just enjoying that, aren't you?
Yeah.
Want to make another one?
No, make something else.
What else could I do? I have another one that I made that is pretty good. This one is called a Crazy Red after, you know, Red Lauren from Virginia?
Mm-hmm.
This one's named after him. He actually tried it and he liked it.
Well, that's good.
So, this one is also a wonderful Faygo product because Faygo can do no wrong. And we're running out of ice here, so I'm probably not going to be...
So, is Faygo a Midwestern thing?
Hmm?
Is Faygo a Midwestern thing?
It originated in Michigan. I actually delivered to the Faygo plant because I do, like, dry bulk sugar deliveries.
That explains a lot, because from Georgia, we don't know what Faygo is.
Yeah, if you go south of, like, hopefully Tennessee, most people don't know what Faygo is. I have seen it in, like, some of the southern states, but it's very rare. Only in Michigan can you get, like, every flavor at the local gas station. You can get...
How many pick these at the gas station?
About half of it, yeah. I actually got half a liquor at the gas station, too. Can't do that in Pennsylvania. Any of you guys from Pennsylvania?
Michigan.
Yeah, Michigan.
Yep. All of us, Michigan. Yeah.
Yeah.
Got a little bit. All right, so, to make this, we are going to use Red Pop, which is awesome. How many of you guys have had Rock and Rye? Red cream soda. This stuff is great.
Faygo's actually never touched my lips, so.
What?
You've never had Faygo in Michigan?
I just assumed it was a stupid meme thing.
What is wrong with you? It's
very good.
He doesn't live in Michigan, and he probably drinks tons of this stuff.
Hold on, wait, we have shot glasses. What am I doing? Keep making your drink.
Alright. So, the Crazy Red is more of this super awesome black cherry rum. Mm.
Isn't there a liquor store like right outside the hotel? Yeah, I'm picking up a bottle of that.
A little bit of Red Pop and a little bit of Rock and Rye. And we'll throw a maraschino cherry in there for you. And for those of you who don't know what Rock and Rye is, it's different than Red Pop. It's a red cream soda and not a strawberry cream soda.
There is a difference.
Oh,
yeah, but how would you define the flavor
just smells
of
like
red?
Medicine to me? All of them smell like cold medicine.
Red Pop, if you make it, if you like mix it with ice cream and like blend it up, it makes like a strawberry shake. It's so awesome. And it's carbonated.
I feel like the carbonation would die when you mix it with ice cream.
It just reminds me of all the cold medicine I had.
Have you ever actually had... I used to make this with my dad all the time. Have you ever had dry ice cream? You take your standard ice cream recipe, and instead of using like regular ice cream churn with ice and salt and everything, you actually take a block of dry ice and smash it all up until it's like a fine powder, and you slowly add it in, and it actually makes carbonated ice cream.
Yeah.
You can make ice cream in 15 minutes instead of 2 hours. It's so great.
Well, that's why you just use nitrogen. Okay, so I kid you not, you guys, I just finally figured out what Sub-Zero is. And it is wonderful. Have any of you been there? Okay, thank God I'm not the only one. People make me feel like I'm an idiot because I've never been there. They actually take cream and make ice cream in front of you. They put all the goodies in that you want it, and they literally use liquid nitrogen to make your ice cream in front of you in seconds. And it blew my mind. I haven't finished this one yet.
Have some of that.
Okay, so this was the Faygo Red Pop, the Faygo Red Cream Soda, and what was the liquor?
Black Cherry Rum with maraschino cherries.
Is that in the bottom?
Oh, it's floating in there somewhere.
I just see ice. I think you cheated me. I want a refund.
You just put the juice in there.
Here, you just enjoy the jar.
It's almost
going for round two.
It tastes like one of the Red Jolly Ranchers.
It does, doesn't it?
It does. Like a cherry Jolly Rancher.
You have a thing with Jolly Ranchers, don't you?
No, he said Jolly Rancher, and I said Jolly Rancher.
Yeah, the great thing about half the drinks I make, other than the Iffy Vixen and the Black Cherry Vanilla Rum and Coke, a lot of people, there are people that like, your standard, like your whiskey and your tequila and stuff that you drink straight, or like a gin and tonic or whatever. But then there's the people that like the fruity stuff, they can't handle the beer or just the straight alcohol. And so you gotta make them fruity drinks. The real trick to hosting parties, you gotta make a little of everything and know your audience. Usually fruity things are things that everybody will drink, and so if you do like fruity stuff, you're gonna be everybody's new best friend. And so half the stuff I make tastes like Jolly Rancher because it's so easy to drink, and you're not just like getting a face full of, oh, nah. This just all I can taste is vodka. I don't taste any of the flavor of the other ingredients.
I brought a thing cool. If you want to see that.
Then when you get me home.
What do you got there?
Coconut rum, cranberry, and the stuff floating around is 1.5 lemons about this size and mangoes.
Yeah, bring it up here. We'll give it a sniff.
And that's been jarred since the 31st.
The 31st, eh?
Yeah. So,
3 weeks. Okay, so this is the first time that anyone has ever brought in liquor to share
yes.
with us?
Yes. We're not used to actually having somebody do show and tell unless it's alkaline.
Make sure it's over or something. That way it doesn't like overflow.
And I feel so I feel so loved right
now. Yes. What do you guys think of Odie's apple pie that he brings in?
It's actually very good.
I hate him. He gets me drunk entirely too quick. I was like, oh, that's really good. Give me another one. Oh, that's really good. Give me another one. All of a sudden, I'm in the chair going,
this is what's in the room. You can drink one shot of that and be done.
Yes.
It's very fruity. Feel free to pour a shot if you'd like.
I like
well, technically, since we're drinking stuff up here, I think we can legally sample this candy. Since we are candy. We're already drinking.
Well, it's... As of hotel rules, panelists can do it, no one else can, because it's actually Indiana law. Indiana literally has the strictest laws in the nation when it comes to alcohol.
Yeah, no kidding.
That's interesting.
That will kill me. I will drink that in a gall.
So,
okay, hold on.
My teacher told me that.
He's trying now.
Oh no, I'm
Jake told me that.
You know what we need? Wait, you know what we need to do?
Jake did?
To get around it. This is what needs to happen. Next year,
everybody who shows up gets to be on the panel.
No, I'll try.
If we're all panelists.
Okay, so what's in this again?
Coconut rum. Pirate Bay coconut rum specifically. And then just cranberry juice is so like half and half of that, and then the rest is just mangoes and a lemon and a half. No rind.
So how long do you normally let this sit?
I did it once for like 4 to 5 months, but I think I prefer it where it's only about 3 to 5 weeks.
Damn.
Is that what this is? Like 3 to 5 weeks?
Yes. It has a date on the top.
July 31st.
Okay.
I hate this date. Alright. So
I
know something else.
Hold on a second. I'm actually going to split this shot glass a little bit. Because this smells really impressive. As long as no one tries to stick their tongue in here.
Yeah, I'm
actually
going to
want people to smell this.
I'm only 10 minutes from the hotel.
It took me 30.
The fruit is really good. I found that, like,
okay.
Like,
does anyone want to take a sniff of this? Because this is, like, utterly
tantalizing. You can definitely smell the mango.
Yeah.
It's got a very, mango.
You have to get nice, fresh mango stuff that's like just about to go bad. Like,
it's got
the
very
days,
interesting,
like,
sweet
the firm ones.
Yeah.
Good.
And it literally smells like there's no.
My dad actually makes really good peach mango salsa. I'm gonna actually have to try this.
I was surprised when I tried it. He gave it to me. I actually really like it. I don't like too much for me.
Yeah.
Like
and
I like
I
more
found
of
that
the
I like
drinks,
real
but I like it more towards like the hard.
It's got an extremely like. I'm very impressed.
I
will be alcohol.
It's very aromatic.
Like, I'm extremely impressed with the fact that
usually most of the drinks that I make, depending on what you're putting into them, usually most drinks are not very aromatic. This has a very nice aroma to it, and if you were to put this in a thing of dry ice, you know, you'd have the whole house come out.
Yeah, I like that because I can just sip it all evening. I don't have to have a lot.
I'll pour
some broccoli too.
The really nice thing that you did was taking those rinds off.
Yeah,
so a lot of people leave the rinds on, and the issue with that is the rind actually, as it's sitting in the liquor, starts to deteriorate, and it actually gives it more of an earthy flavor, which is, at least for myself, not pleasing. An earthy flavor to me is when you're getting like a Cabernet or something like that, and that should not be my hard liquor. That's why I don't use scotch or whiskey.
Yeah, I have my roommate that I'm rooming with, he likes, are you familiar with Islay malt scotch?
No, because I literally do not drink scotch.
It tastes like you're drinking a campfire. All you can taste is like
weird
smoky pea.
Yeah.
That's all it is.
Did you say smoky pea?
Yes. It's very smoky and it's very peaty because they filter it through peat moss.
Yeah. Peaty. Yes. I heard pea. like smoky pee, like you peed on fire. And I'm like, what? That's that makes more sense now.
No, believe it or not, that's about what it tastes like, too.
Yeah.
I don't know how he drinks it. He likes that hard bag.
How many of you like scotch or whiskey or things like that?
It's fine in a cocktail or something.
I can drink it straight, but I also like it mixed.
There's one that
I
was going to drink.
Toast, that's it. Everything like, else makes me like gag.
The only whiskey I actually drink is have you ever had, it's called Jeremiah Weed Sarsaparilla Whiskey.
No, I have not had that.
It tastes exactly like A&W root beer. It's actually really good. If you mix it with A&W root beer and a little bit of Ready Whip on top. Because, you know, who doesn't love whipped cream?
And you're basically making an alcoholic root beer float.
Yeah, it's so good. I actually have a bottle of it at home, but I forgot to bring it.
I just end up with whipped cream. It would never make it dirty. I have the reason I keep my wonderful figure.
I have way too many. How are we doing that time?
You've got
I mean,
9 o'clock. Exactly.
Okay, so A, I don't know who screwed up the sign outside. This is technically till 9. But B, we're the only panel in here, so as long as we want to go, we can go.
And I don't have anything to do until
unless Mickey comes in here and drags me out by my, you know, the scruff of my neck and yells at me.
Because I don't have anything to do till 10 at MST3K anyways, so.
If that's the case, can I take the black hair thing over to Alkaline?
So, like, I'm fine and chilling here.
So, the only problem with that is alcohol is not supposed to go into con space. So, when we do this, we're going to make it a field trip thing, and since...
Well,
I think we can get away with that. If we're making a field trip to deliver it to him. Either with that, or should his panel be open? Didn't open mic in the
aisle?
What?
The rule is you cannot be stagnant with it, but as long as you're moving from point A to point B.
If it is in a hotel bar glass. These are not hotel bar glass. Although,
especially this.
Although last year I did get bar glasses so I could take these back to my room.
Open mic is until 9:30.
So at 9:30 we bring Alkali down here and force him to drink some things.
Do you want some more ice?
Yeah.
No.
Yeah.
I would not wish that on my worst. How many of you have ever actually tried Malort?
Oh. It tastes like best way to describe it is. Have you ever been
you
to
didn't
to
want
to
admit it at first, did you? We were here last year. We did this last year, and we decided we're never going to do this again.
I almost died in this room last year because of you guys and my... Oh, Malort! I had never heard of it before last year. Malort's wonderful. It tastes amazing. So Alkali and I do a shot. I literally drop to my knees and start gagging.
You know, still has it on video.
Have you ever been to a bonfire and somebody threw on particle board onto the fire?
Yes.
That tastes how that smells.
Oh, God.
My best description for Malort... It's a face full of burning tires,
yes.
Pencil shavings, an ashtray, and rotten orange peel.
Damn, that sounds good.
I want to try this.
Just shut up, Benji.
Yes, if you it's only sold in Chicago. So if you ever go to Chicago,
Crown
go to.
Wait. I get it.
Really?
Yes. I know how they age it. They age it in the rotting holds of decaying ships.
Probably. It wouldn't
surprise. No, they just.
They do burn out on the fucking barrels.
I just want to say something kind of mean. It's probably aged in the basement of McCormick Place.
That's a good one.
My boyfriend's from Chicago, so I can say that. It's
Alkali and Drago are from Chicago. I think we can say it too.
I don't know how anybody can stomach this stuff. Taste does not leave your mouth. You have to have like four chasers just to get rid of that burning tire taste.
I have seen someone chug a bottle of it.
Why?
And sit the bottle down and look at me and go, what's next? And I went, how have you not died?
That's someone you don't want to mess with.
You don't want to mess with
him. Sure that person wasn't Alkali.
It was not Alkali.
Really?
It was not. I think I found someone who can beat Alkali.
Really?
Yes. He's very trained.
That's worrying.
I know Shadowcat can drink that stuff straight.
It's not Kage, is it?
Oh God, no.
Kage,
I don't think Kage can touch that.
No.
To be honest, if you really think about it, Kage actually doesn't drink that much. He mostly just sticks to his wine.
Yeah.
And when you actually watch him during his panels, you only see him taking like these tiny little sips. He might finish one glass in the pan. That's about it.
Yeah.
So
he's not as drunk as everybody thinks. He just puts on a show because he makes us all games.
So one of the things of a good mixologist is you can look at your liquors, look at your mixers, things like that, and come up with new ideas on the fly.
Based on what you have left.
And I'm really wanting to try something. Never made this before, and we'll actually name it tonight, depending on how bad it tastes. But normally, I'm pretty good at making drinks that taste good if I
have
ice.
I'm chubby.
Yeah, we're a little low. We're a little out.
I had that. Is there a drink called the Tire Fire?
That is Malort.
That is Malort. Drink a bottle of Malort, and that's literally it. I'm actually thinking about trying to come up with a drink that you mix Malort with something else and call it Flint Water.
Oh.
Just
I may have one that you can use. It's called Old Poe Bourbon, and it is probably the nastiest bourbon on the planet.
Really?
Yes.
Is that like is that like the bourbon equivalent to like Burnett's or Mohawk vodka?
Yes. This is basically the equivalent of get this moonshine from Cletus down in the holler.
Okay. Yeah. Just because you had to go and say that. Real awkward, quick story, but I find it very interesting. So my grandparents on my mother's side actually met and are the only reason that I exist, because my grandfather actually made and ran moonshine, and the FBI actually hired my grandmother to bust my grandpa, and she ended up falling in love with him at a movie theater, It was way back when there were movie theaters.
That's dangerous now.
But they were born in like 1940 something. But they went to a drive-in on their first date, and my grandpa used to smoke. So she was supposed to be busting him for the FBI. He tried to make a move on her, and she said, "I will not kiss you as long as you smoke." He threw his cigarette out the car window and said, "Done." They ended up running off together, getting married in Indiana, and he never smoked from that day, actually.
Really?
Man of his word, believe it or not.
Sounds like a pretty awesome grandfather.
I mean, he did come home one year, like, literally no shirt and no shoes in a snowstorm because he literally gave them off his back, so.
What you mixing right now?
I don't know. We're gonna see how it tastes first.
What's in it?
Well, you should have been paying attention, right?
We're also listening to an awesome story of your
we're gonna see what you think of it first before I admit what I put in it.
That's always worrying.
I know, I saw it smell interesting.
Hopefully it's not horrible.
Hopefully
I got a wild hair and I wanted to see what it would taste like.
That's actually really good. It tastes like a watermelon. I don't know where I got watermelon, but it tastes like watermelon.
Okay, so what I actually just mixed was Tito's vodka, this peach tree schnapps, some, is that actually sweet and sour or is that margarita mix?
That's sweet and sour.
Sweet and sour. And Sprite.
Really?
And it does kind of taste like watermelon.
Try it.
I just drank it.
Smell this. I mean, there's nothing watermelon related in this. It smells, it tastes exactly like a watermelon Jolly Rancher. I shit you not.
You and Jolly Ranchers.
So I'm
Jolly
just
Ranchers
say
are before so everyone else.
That
they are amazing, but
oh, so
I
got a slice.
I'm not taking up the watermelon. So the reason that I love bartending so much is when people come up to my bar and look at me and go, "What do you have tonight?" And I do my stupid little spiel of, "Here's what I have on tap, and here's my special, and here's this, and here's that." And then they look at me and go, "Surprise me with something that's not on the menu."
Oh,
and I'm like, "Thanks for letting me go through the whole spiel."
I don't know.
It smells like watermelon.
It's so well. There's no watermelon.
But just, in all honesty, it's thinking of that. You know what peach tastes like, what vodka tastes like, you know what Sprite tastes like, things like that. And you start to intertwine those thoughts, and that's how things like this are born.
That's
like,
why I mix up that moment.
I have a feeling that Chasten just invented the artificial flavoring they use in watermelon Jolly Ranchers without using watermelon anything.
So what are we going to call this? I'm letting all of you figure out a name for
this. Yes, we need a good name for this.
Not watermelon. can't believe it's not watermelon.
I can't believe it's not watermelon. So we've got a I can't believe it's not watermelon. We've got a cheers, Governor. Anybody else?
The Alabama Slammer.
That's already a drink.
The Alabama Slammer 2, Electric Boogaloo.
I think he's drunk.
Indie Fruit Con.
Indie Fruit Con.
Ooh. I do like that.
We just made an IFC in a glass.
Oh. IFC in a glass.
Okay, how about
not enough cum or
wait.
And then you describe it.
That's the other thing we forgot. Now, who's in cum ops right now? Is Nikki in there?
I can go check.
If Nikki is in there, bring her down here and stuff that I demand the presence of the queen. Do not tell her there's an emergency. She will freak out and kill me.
Yeah, someone's on the ground, frothing at the mouth. We think it's alcohol related.
Is she the one that dealt with the Rosa Parks elevator story? What? The story?
I want to hear the story.
Yes, we would love to hear it. This is what started that whole issue with the frat boys here. The suitor was trying to get on an elevator and...
Oh, she's not a suitor.
No, I'm not saying that she's a suitor, but...
Oh, okay.
Someone... I need to tell the whole story, otherwise it doesn't make sense. Suitor was trying to get on, frat boys were in the elevator, they stopped them, said you can't get on. They're like, but I just want to go to my room, and the doors start closing, like, you ain't Rosa Parks, you can't come on this elevator. And they immediately went to con ops and told that... Pandas heard the story, told the story to someone, don't know if that's her or not, and she goes, oh, hell no, and then books it. And that's when there was the flyers everywhere saying, frat boys need an emergency meeting now. So that's what that started, and then just cheering and finally getting along with someone. Is that her? She runs
the story? I don't think that would have been her.
You said the queen, so I was wondering if that was her, maybe.
So, when Nikki took over for Pandas, we all call her the queen. Inevitably, I'm the other cat. So
alright, it's gonna be good.
Good evening, I am queen. Your princess has summoned you. Is this the one?
Yes.
Oh. I was like, what the hell did you just hand me?
They made IFC in a glass.
So these wonderful folks have named this Indie Fruit Con.
It's so good.
We promise there is
and
no
and hold on, before you drink it. This was just me doing a random mix of it. Different things.
There is
I
no
just weapon. Decided that I think this should go in there, this should go in there, this should go in there, and that should go in there.
There is no
other
way.
We want your honest opinion as to what it tastes like, and we will tell you what's in it afterwards.
Mm-hmm. Here's much hesitation. Sprite.
Oh, she's gonna try to guess.
This is weird enough. This one.
Wait, I'm gonna stand behind you, and it's.
What, you
so you just Sprite and smear off.
Yeah, the Sprite and this junk.
Okay, what
this
else? There are four ingredients in there.
Pineapple one.
There's a flavor in there that you're missing, but you're wondering why it's not on the table.
There's no
peed in this.
I would have been out for life, but he's not in here, so.
So what does it taste like to you?
Mountain Dew.
Mountain Dew? Okay.
You know what? I can see that, because if you let Mountain Dew go flat enough, it will taste like watermelon. Mm.
So,
don't ask me how I know that.
What? How do you know
that? So, Tito's vodka.
By making horrible, horrible mistakes.
The sweet and sour and Sprite.
See, and I was eyeing that sweet and sour.
And we are completely unsure as to how we got a watermelon flavor out of things that have nothing to do with watermelon.
I can taste the teeth of peach now. Not just that. Like, I get that.
Yeah.
By the way, we have one for Alkali, too.
I was going to say, so the whole reason...
For him.
So, no, we have something else for him.
Oh,
that's another reason why I brought you down here. We want to take a field trip and deliver a couple of drinks to Alkali. But you're the only one that can say yes or no. Then can you drag him down here and make him drink them before...
No.
We know he's.
Oh,
he has,
well,
a,
then,
he has, yeah, a, he has a 30 minute gap, yeah, so he has to come down here in that 30 minutes and drink these.
Okay.
Have you ever that had black cherry vanilla rum and coke?
No.
It's made with your favorite rum.
Yes, it is made with the black cherry cruising.
Not a big fan of vanilla.
Because she likes cherry.
It's true.
Well, technically you can do the same thing with just regular Coke, but...
It's not bad. Oh, that's my go-to. No, I take that back. The Dr. Pepper is my go-to.
No one hurts, she'll drink the straight stuff of this.
I may or may not have already done that.
This is the one that I probably should start working on this before too long.
5, 7, 12, 15?
I don't know, there's no counties.
Touch some of this.
Oh my god.
I want to try that one so bad.
This is called a Angry Blue Fox. This is named after
this whole as I am!
Whenever it's this is named after Hexafox, if you know.
See, whenever it's that time, it's known as the Angry Big Blue Fox.
Tastes like a green jelly rancher, doesn't it?
Yeah.
That is pineapple rum,
Utopia,
Fago cream soda, Mountain Dew Voltage, and Smirnoff Green Apple Vodka.
It looks kind of like a thermometer, though. I want some refreshment.
Yeah, this is my, you know, I go get trashed around the time glass.
Which you didn't just say to the contrary.
Of course not.
Yeah.
He doesn't do it here.
About that.
He doesn't do it here, just other cons.
Not your cons.
All right, I'm going to set this down and get some food in my stomach.
What?
Do you have any drinks?
Possibly. Yeah, I was like, I got pulled. I got pulled over here. I'm not complaining.
That's like the other cardinal rule. You're supposed to eat before you drink. If you drink on an empty stomach, that's just bad juju.
Exactly.
Don't point at me.
Drink water.
He was smart. He ate before he came here.
Water.
Right?
I didn't have time to do that. My food's sitting in the fridge.
It's still sitting in the fridge?
I had to call and reschedule car services.
Yeah, fair enough.
So, I'm enjoying my alcohol, though.
Yeah, he's having a wonderful first con night.
So, by a show of hands, does your favorite drink include rum?
The more I try, the more.
What if it just is rum with us?
That includes rum. Your favorite drink includes vodka. Okay. I was hoping for more, but whiskey.
Just straight. We have one of them.
What is your favorite drink? Just everything from the kitchen sink. Scotch. Tequila.
Again, don't have multiple favorites.
I mean, I guess.
Yeah, tequila sunrise.
Ooh, tequila sunrise. That is a good drink.
Tequila Mockingbird.
Yes, we did make a tequila sunrise last year.
It was very good.
So wait, what is your favorite liquor?
My liquor is rum. I have like 15 to 20 different brands and bottles of rum on my liquor shelf at home. My parents come over and they're like, "Are you an alcoholic?" I'm like, "No, I just collect exotic rum." I have a bottle of Captain Morgan Tattoo that's unopened. They discontinued that like 3 years ago. I got it from a friend who somehow managed to pick one up at Binny's in Chicago. I'm like, "This is discontinued. Can you give me a bottle of it?" He's like, "I think so. They had it at Binny's." I'm like, "Go and buy me every bottle you can find." And I'm really sad they discontinued it because it's so good. You can drink it straight.
I'm just curious if you guys have an opinion of that crystal skull vodka I keep hearing about.
I've tried it. It is not good. I don't know why people pay $100 for it. You're really only paying for the fancy jar glass thing.
Yeah. Yeah.
Is it because Dan Aykroyd is lunatic?
Yes.
Possibly. My personal favorite vodka is actually a tie between, have any of you guys ever had Snow Leopard vodka? I have not been able to find it in Michigan. You can buy it, I think they source it through New York is where they import it. It is very, very smooth and it's really good. The second closest thing that I've been able to find to that is called Ugly Dog and that is produced in Michigan. It is very, very, very
smooth. What is your...
There's alkali.
I just told you I had a drink for me, I'm in.
We have a couple of residents.
Okay. Family,
yes.
It can
so,
be
this is so nice
to
hear.
Wait, hold on. Wait, hold on. No, don't drink that yet.
Okay.
we're gonna play a game.
I like games.
So
there's a lot of cherry in here.
You're going to drink this.
I'm gonna drink that.
You're going to drink this and then you're going to tell me what is in it. You played this game with Nikki. We're gonna do this the same way that we did before.
Nikki lost.
Nikki didn't lose, so let's see if Alkali can do it. The professional.
The fairy knows.
Sour apple. Sprite? Is there Sprite in this? I'm going with sour apple and Sprite to start without tasting.
Four ingredients.
It's four?
Mm-hmm.
Yep. Is it two different kinds of apple in here?
I can't tell you that.
Oh, I thought that's what I was doing. I'm sorry.
No, you've got to guess the four ingredients and then we'll tell you. So you've guessed two.
I'm guessing Sprite, two unknown forms of apple, one of which I'm going to guess is a Smirnoff because it has the very
kind
of
oily.
Can I just look at the table too?
Yeah, it's all up here.
You can guess what's in this based on what we have on here.
This. The fuck is that? I wasn't expecting that. This. There's something in here I'm not catching. I'm gonna drink the whole fucking glass.
It's alcohol.
Well, don't forget,
you are more than welcome to drink the whole glass.
I'm actually gonna have to guess because I think I'm wrong. I'm torn between these two. I'm gonna go with the flavor thing that is totally masked because you put too much of this in. Not too much, but it's overpowered.
Believe it or not, you are completely wrong.
I am
wrong.
Except for one.
Wrong. Wrong.
No way! This is totally.
No.
There's no sweet in here.
There is none.
There's not sweet and sour in here. That's disgusting.
These are your four ingredients.
Alkali.
Okay, no, I'm actually rushed. You masked everything. That's very well mixed.
Alkali.
Are you getting a watermelon Jolly Rancher flavor out of that?
No, I have been fucking drinking and smoking all day. I'm getting no flavor, but it's delicious.
I can't taste
anything,
but this tastes right.
It totally does. Oh, God, I have more drinks. Okay, hold on. So my real guess is these four bottles, and I win.
This is how you do
it. How does he do it?
How does he do it?
Yeah, this one just smells like sugar. But we haven't shared a drink yet.
This is black.
So I find it really interesting that both of them went for the sour apple. So you can obviously tell that we weren't lying. There was some sort of sour taste behind it.
The sweet and sour that you're putting in, and then masking the other two. That's the beauty of vodka. If you're gonna put vodka in a drink, don't call it a wild card or a cheat code. But it is. Vodka is a beautiful, beautiful mixer. Vodka just says, tonight I would like to wake up with someone else who I may or may not know their name.
This is true.
This is very
peach schnapps, honest to God, I would never have guessed peach schnapps in there.
Hey,
but that's the sweet and sour. Sweet and sour covers so much. You can do, like, this is just, look, that's viscous. That should not be in a goddamn drink.
Good shit, though, yeah.
Oh, it's the best master. Sweet and sour, simple syrup, true grenadine. None of that fucking. If you're buying grenadine in a plastic bottle and it just tastes like cherry and sugar, that is not grenadine. Real grenadine comes in a glass bottle and it is pomegranate, not cherry. Grenadine is an amazing mixer, kind of worth buying the extra bottle. Sweet and sour is just a wonderful mask.
Grenadine is one of the primary ingredients in a alien brain hemorrhage. And
I'm going to walk away before you make one of those.
The good news is...
Are we out of white girl spritzer?
I'm sorry, how gay are you that you have spritzers up here? Oh God, you have the fucking alcoholic water!
Yes!
That is wrong! That is wrong!
Guess what? When you come up to my suite later, the fridge is filled with this.
I'm gonna need multiple straws. Who here has had the alcoholic water? Okay, you have. Have you had, or you guys too, have you had the unflavored alcoholic water?
Yes.
Oh, well, let me take you on a journey. Have you ever vomited in into your soul.
Here's unflavored alcoholic water. Only 6%.
Wait, what?
6% water.
Oh, 6% water. I'm going to let you get back to your panel, but I did see this on the table. I want to say that. Once again, I just want to remind everyone, Everclear is literally, not figuratively, literally not meant for human consumption. No. There is a mixing spirit. You use it to float and light stuff on fire.
You can put it in your gas tank.
Why don't you drink Everclear?
Because it gets about halfway down and it comes straight back up.
That is part of it. What's that burn from Everclear? What's the burn from booze? What is that? It goes down your throat.
Death.
That's the booze burn. You're not used to it. What's the burn from Everclear? That is a chemical burn. You are literally burning your esophagus. That is not meant to be drank straight.
Neither is Malort.
Malort is not meant to be drank. Malort is what happens after an enema. Not Malort.
I was telling them earlier that I'm actually planning on...
Who made this one?
Me.
This is very good.
No.
I don't know how much
he did.
Was the Roman Coco, yes.
Yeah, no, this is good too. Yeah. I've never drank sweet and sour. This is a good drink.
This is the first year that we've actually had someone do show and tell.
Oh, what's that?
This kid.
They want that for us to try, and it is
how long is
wonderful.
It age?
3 weeks.
3 weeks?
The very first.
Yes.
I've tried it longer, but you really put it on there.
It.
I can't open my
here. Dude, don't worry about it. Oh, never mind. I'm a pussy.
Here.
Okay, you got it. You're free to guess what's in it, too, if you want.
I'm peaches.
Hey!
Are you coming to pre-game?
I like that.
Sure. I think I need to make him a rum and coke too, because I know how much.
Hold on. I do apologize. I love the drink. I'm about to drink cider and beer all night. He can share it with me. Splitting drinks like that is a bad idea. Ladies and gentlemen, give it up for Lord Panda! All right. So this is show and tell.
This is show and tell.
Okay, so you're showing me, now tell me, what'd you do?
So what is the myth about?
Tell them, I can hear you. Turn around and tell them. You already know?
Yeah, okay. This much pirate made coconut rum, and then the rest is cranberry juice.
It brought me to my knees.
Oh, this is going to be delicious.
And then it's a lemon and a half, and mango.
Oh, that's mango, that's not peach, that's mango. I'm excited.
I tried peaches, it's really good. It's smooth, too.
It has a very good aroma to it.
So it's
like, in all honesty, if I could, I would want that to be my next Airwick, like, plug-in.
My black cherry recipe, and then I add lemon. Black cherry and cranberry.
Oh.
It's quite good.
Dude.
It's strong.
Right before I suck a dick, I'm going to drink that because I'm cuckering like a motherfucker.
I brought two bottles.
That is a very delicious drink, and I can tell that you've let it age because it's really, you're right, it's really mellowed out. Mm-hmm. That's a very tasty drink.
Yeah.
It'll take six cases.
You do talk at your panel.
Milo.
Wait, what is
this? Start marketing this. Something alcohol.
Oh, Mixology, right?
Yeah,
we need to just create, like, a 13-month.
Let's get smashed.
You're answering the MST3K question
every year.
The panel, the movie, the show.
Oh, MST3K is happening at 10 o'clock at secondary events, but that's not what this panel is about. Continue.
Yes, it is. This is
This is a wonderful...
You are welcome to take
this about the
This is called a free game.
This is called an Angry Blue Fox named after Hex the Fox from Michigan.
That's a really long name.
It's
a big
I'm going to call this butt plug. Des!
I'm going to call it spring onion, because that's literally what it looks like.
Oh.
I like that name.
It's a big giant onion.
How are you going to straw that long?
There's a popper on the bottom. I love it.
Not bad. That's actually not bad at all. Yeah. That's more mellow than I expected it to be.
More what?
Mellow.
Oh, I thought you said metal. I was like, it's that also.
It's more metal.
It's so metal.
Here's a wonderful little trick you can learn. Look at the color of your drink. That color will let you get an idea of how much sugar is going to be in it. And me and sugar don't really get along. This one is actually a very nice combination of booze and sugar.
Green jelly.
This looks like pure sugar.
This is just lemonade.
It's okay. I brought my insulin.
Insulin?
I brought my insulin. You're fine.
No, alcohol. Insulin dildo.
Alcohol. Are you actually diabetic? Are you actually diabetic?
Borderline. I was diagnosed, but I was able to diet.
Oh my god, his tail is moving.
Wait, his tail just moves?
Yes.
You are so happy.
Then why?
It goes every minute.
Oh, okay.
Okay. Oh, that's
very good.
So if you wait long.
So what are you guys talking about? What was your last topic?
The worst drink you've ever had. I know yours.
Oh, yeah.
I made you drink it.
Worst drink you've ever had, does.
No, we need an order concrete mixer.
Concrete mixer is a joke drink. I think that should be illegal. I get what you're saying. That is the worst drink, but it's supposed to be
the worst. So what is the mixed drink for the person who doesn't drink?
That would be
that
Midori and Sprite.
Malibu rum and Diet Dr. Pepper.
Also works.
Malibu rum, Diet Dr. Pepper.
Or that.
Coke and rum might be just...
A rum and Coke, a classic rum and Coke, there's nothing wrong with, but when you talk about somebody who doesn't drink, a rum and Coke does not... when I say mask, what I'm talking about is when you drink a drink, has anyone ever had a drink and you thought, oh man, this is dangerous, because you're not really tasting alcohol.
He had one of those. That is in this job.
Exactly. See, and those are
I can
actually,
make you one of those real
quick. Hold on, I don't like those usually. Because usually that is covered with sugar. That being said, there are exceptions, and these gentlemen have given me two of them already. Very, very well done. That's masking.
This is basically Malibu, coconut rum, and pineapple juice.
Oh yeah, that's it. They're also called screwdrivers. I mean, screwdriver is a perfect mask. Tequila and orange juice.
Well, okay then. Hi there.
Hi. Tequila and orange juice, vodka and lemonade. Cranberry and vodka.
Yeah.
Those are all basically good masks. A rum and Coke, the rum still comes through. There's a spice to a rum and Coke that you're supposed to experience. One of the world's greatest mask drinks that's incredibly hard to do. I don't know if you gentlemen know how to make one.
I did not make this last year. This is called a Yiffy Vixen.
Love your names.
I named them after people I know.
So to answer your question, the best mask drink is still a professionally made Long Island iced tea. Mm-hmm. There's nothing like it in the world. It is dangerous. A hurricane is close to.
Fun fact, when I used to live over at Purdue University, I don't know any of you from Indiana, but Purdue University, I bartended on campus and I was actually voted best Long Island in the city.
It tastes exactly like
Long Island, if you do make it right, two of those, and you should be out
like
the
five of these.
If not,
you're dead until like.
Because Long Island is actually four different alcohols mixed together in that drink.
That is my signature drink. I make this for parties all the time.
I'm going to meet the person who inspired me.
Yeah, like, I don't
the
like
Long
it,
Island.
But, like,
no,
it's
the
Yiffy.
So if you had that
experience. I do apologize. That just happened. We're all starting to drink. We're all talking over each other. Why don't you talk to them?
I actually made two versions of this drink. The original version that I made at MFF GasCon 2014.
Don't call it that!
Was regular.
Hashtag GasCon!
I went to pineapple rum because it seemed to blend better.
There's more sugar in pineapple rum.
And because you can put as much pineapple rum in there as you want, you can't taste the rum.
You can't taste the rum in pineapple rum. There's just no rum flavor left.
So yeah, like I said, I make like punch bowls of this stuff. People drink it all day long and don't realize there's any rum in it until I told them, like, that big ass punch bowl you see there, there's like 2 fifths of rum in there.
And that's how they died.
That's how they go to the hospital like a Sam Party that one time.
May I play a game with them really fast?
Go right ahead.
I heard a while ago you were talking about the worst drink you ever drank. We're playing a game called 5 Second Story. I do apologize. I want to stick around. I got to go set up MST3K, which means I need to find a TV. So before I leave, I want to hear your 5 Second Story, even if you already told it. You have 5 seconds to tell the story. What's your worst drink? You have 5 seconds, not a second more. Go.
I took half of this once.
That's a bad fucking drink.
I drank girls' pee once.
Competition. You won. Worst thing you ever drank. Who's got a 5 second story? The worst thing you ever drank. What do you got?
I worked at an orange juice tonic water.
We have all.
Why bother with the tonic water?
We got every drink orange juice.
Or no.
I've got one worse than this.
Quick.
Dip. I actually drank from somebody's.
Going over here now. What the fuck? We got.
It looks like that.
Hold on, did you just say absinthe and whiskey?
Yes, by complete accident.
What the
How
fuck?
How is that an accident?
How do you fuck that up?
Well,
good question.
That ended in a gutter foaming from the mouth.
It was not me who mixed it.
That is terrifying. Absinthe is good in one way and one way only, and that is the traditional way to serve absinthe.
Yes.
If you like straight absinthe, that's wonderful. Good for you, and that's great. You are missing out on some of the flavors. Absinthe is made to be served in a specific way because it opens up the bouquet, and that matters way more than you think, because never forget how a glass is shaped. There are two senses involved with drinking. One is taste, obviously, and the second is smell. And if you ever think that smell has nothing to do with drinking, wrong. Try drinking when you have a cold and tell me how delicious anything is.
Yeah, like, no.
For example, that.
That's as wonderful.
That right there, I was telling them earlier, if you put it in a punch bowl with dry ice, it makes this creamsicle fog that rolls through
the
house.
That's cool. That is cool.
And then everybody comes and drinks it, and then they all die.
That's less cool, but I understand. Gentlemen, I do apologize. I need to go get a TV into secondary events, and I cannot tell you the movie. There is a reason I can't do that. I'll tell you why it happened. It's just a general rule.
It's a law.
Okay.
I'm going to follow alkali. What would it take?
Roman Coke.
I'm going to take a Roman Coke.
Alkali. What would it take to drink with
EMS? I filled up the panel about 1 minute ago at my last panel. I'm so sorry. Guys, thank you again for inviting me to the panel. Guys, you're wonderful.
Thank you, alkali.
Floyd. Thank you very much, Floyd. I smoked a lot right before the shut up.
Give me a hand over Alkali, everybody. Until he got a life and knew how to do smart things.
God.
So, do you guys have any questions for us over anything so far?
The minis. We never talked about them.
This is actually. Basically, I just got a cheaper, smaller package version of Bailey's. We didn't end up using Bailey's because I forgot the grenadine, so we couldn't make it go from the abortion shop.
Okay.
Can you still make the alien like normal?
It still requires grenadine.
Can you make something similar to it?
Say, we have...
The phone says no.
Say, do we have the ingredients for concrete mixer?
Hold on a second here. Hello? How do I make this work? Okay, so you're on speakerphone in the middle of my panel. What was that?
Hi, we're here.
Oh, well, you should show up.
We will make you a drink.
Where are you? Well, what panel are you at?
Look at the schedule.
The panel's over. They don't know where we are.
Love you. Yes.
Or they are
so I guess we have one more drink to make.
What name is going to stick for the drink?
Oh.
I like the IFC one. Because it really goes along kind of like the Hawaiian theme with tropical fruits, things like that.
Before we forget in our drunken stupor, write that down so you can make it again.
Oh no, that's already in my hand.
It's on video.
I don't want to see what this looks like. It scares me when I look
at it. With Bailey's, do we have the ingredients to make a improv concrete mixer?
No. And I'm glad we don't.
Because you wouldn't want to drink that afterwards.
No.
You just pour it down the drain.
Have any of you guys ever played King's Cup? No. Tell them about King's Cup.
Okay, which version of King's Cup?
Your version of King's Cup.
Okay, well, the version of King's Cup that I've played, there's actually two versions. Well, technically I've played three versions. So one is, cards are centered around a beer can, and you play cards, each card has a different meaning, and each time you play a card, you slip it under the tap of the beer can. You're supposed to have your own drink. Once someone pops the top of the beer can, you have 10 seconds to open it and chug it. Next version of this, that I've played, is there's a cup in the middle of the ring of cards. You go through and you're drawing cards. Each person pours a little bit of whatever drink they've mixed into this cup.
See, that's the version I'm familiar with.
If someone breaks the circle around the cup, they then have to chug that cup.
Yes, that's the version I'm familiar with.
I do know of this.
The terrible thing about that particular version is if you get, you know, people that have mixed drinks that have like fruity stuff that all mixes together, that can actually taste, you know, halfway respectable. Mm-hmm. Then you get the one asshole that's like, I'm going to put beer in everybody else's fruity mixed drink, and it's just like, Or you get the one person that he probably knows drinks before.
So, the worst King's Cup I ever saw was actually at a Theta K, I don't remember what they were called. It was a frat party that I got drunk to. Anyways, when the king's ring was broken and someone had to drink from the cup, at that time there had been a natty light poured in.
Oh, God.
There was straight vodka poured in. Someone had a rumchata and coke. Someone had Bailey's and something else.
Yeah.
And there was a vodka cranberry, I want to say a margarita. That had all been mixed in a cup.
Yikes.
The guy drank it, looked at us and said, "Fuck you," and ran out the front door. And we went out there and he was in the bushes. Yes. And the worst part was the house rule was if you puked, you then had to, what was it? It was something really gross, like super cheap. It was a super cheap whiskey, but you had to do 5 shots of it back to back. And he immediately ran back outside, was in the bushes. Poor guy.
So out of curiosity, for those of you that like vodka, what is the worst vodka you've ever had?
It was a white vodka, and it was inside a cocktail, and that's all I could taste.
Well,
like,
that's not very descriptive.
I know, that's my
I have a friend of mine that lives up in Hudsonville, Michigan, and we had this little friendly competition. He's like, "We're going to see who can come up with the worst liquor ever." I'm like, "Okay, what do you got for me?" He's like, "All right, we're going to go to the liquor store." So we go to the liquor store, and he's showing me the bottom shelf of the vodka section. And so we're like, "Okay, we got a couple options. We got Kamchatka, we've got Burnett's, and we've got, oh, this one's Mohawk. It's only $4 a bottle. Let's try this." Mohawk vodka is probably the worst vodka I've ever had, but it's still not as bad as Malort. Malort is the god of bad alcohol. Do not ever drink Malort unless you're in Chicago. Then drink lots of Malort.
So alcohol tip, like number 27 for the evening. When you are at a liquor store, do you realize that your liquors are actually tiered on the shelves?
Pick that up when he's mentioned the bottom one.
The bottom shelf is your, "My ass is broke and I want a hangover in the morning." Your top shelf is the, "I'm really bougie and want to look fancy." Your middle shelf is the, "I'm a furry and I'm going to a convention and I don't want to look like trash, but I also don't want to look like I'm a jerk." So that's what I normally go for.
Yeah.
Go for it is that middle shelf.
Usually the way it goes is bottom stuff is like, "I'm drinking to get drunk, I don't care what it tastes like." Middle shelf is like, "Okay, this is good, I'm willing to pay, you know, a little bit of money for decent liquor." Top shelf is like, "Okay, I'm going to buy this for, you know, holy shit, $120 for a bottle of whiskey? Okay, I'll take some of that and drink it maybe, you know, one shot a year."
Yeah.
And, like, beat my roommate if they try to ever get into it.
And if you can't pronounce what is on the bottle, you probably should not drink it.
There was my roommate for this convention, he was at a Vinny's in Chicago. He went up to Renfest a couple of weeks ago up in Bristol.
Mm-hmm.
He went into Binnie's. They had a $5,000 bottle of scotch locked up in this little case. And he took a picture of it, and he's like, "They won't even take this out of the case for me unless I can prove that I actually have $5,000.
Oh, wow.
Who the fuck spends $5,000 on a bottle of scotch? I think he said it was like a 25-year scotch or something.
I've seen it before.
It's like, really?
Well,
It's more a bragging rights than anything.
We've got 15 minutes before Alkali starts drinking his liver away again, and I'm sure people want to go see that.
Oh, yeah.
But before we take off, do you guys have any questions for us? Anything else you want to know? Like, anything like that?
Should we talk about bitters at all?
Bitters is, I love it and I hate it.
I hear a lot about it, but no one explains it very well.
So, bitters, there are very few drinks that I personally feel bitters actually enhances. Bitters is one of those items that, especially kind of, I don't want to say old-timey drinks, but literally old-fashioned Manhattans, things like that, you use bitters in. Bitters, at least from my experience, I honestly do not use bitters that much.
I don't either.
But it normally pairs with whiskeys or bourbons. when you're making more straight up drinks with those, not straight up, but more drinks that focus on the actual taste and flavor of whiskey and bourbons. So,
cool. That makes more sense.
That's why I never use it because I don't like whiskey and bourbon.
Yeah, so I'm not a fan either. Like I said, the only thing I ever use whiskey for is the sarsaparilla whiskey that I was telling them about making earlier, the A&W root beer a little bit, making the root beer float. That's actually pretty good. Other than that, the only thing I use whiskey for is barbecue sauce. Believe it or not, whiskey actually makes for really good barbecue sauce. It gives it a nice smoky flavor.
Anybody else? Any questions?
Oh, we have one in the back.
Do you guys have enough vodka to soak a 5-pound gummy bear?
Excuse me, what? 5-pound gummy bear? Where the hell do you get a 5-pound gummy bear?
Okay. It's in the end. Go to most convenient stores.
I'm kind of worried now.
Yeah, how do? What about jello shots or like gummy bear shots? I know gummy bears, you just soak them.
I've never actually made jello shots.
I hear you puke a lot with those, so.
Okay, so here's the thing. When you come, what a lot of people don't think about is, so for example, gummy bears. Gummy bears, when you soak them, they take in the alcohol, but they still taste rather sweet. Like, you can tell that there's an alcohol flavor to them, but they're still rather sweet. And people think, gummy bears, and eat them like they would normal gummy bears. So they get that really bad reaction of lots of sugar and lots of alcohol, and that's why they get sick.
Okay.
Soaked gummy bears are something you want to take in moderation.
Kind of like the drink I was going to make, Terracoon's Revenge.
Yes.
That one had Surge, Everclear, Sweet and Sour, and the green Smirnoff Pucker, and a little bit of Sprite.
When it comes to jello shots, those can be finicky sometimes when you make them.
Mm-hmm.
You do have to keep in mind the types. When it comes to jello shots, you want to try to stick more with clear liquors and try not to do any mixing with it, because if you think about it, your jello essentially already has a flavor to it.
Yeah.
So when you start getting into more of like, if you wanted to try to mix a black cherry rum, the issue is the extra sugar can sometimes offset that, so your jello won't set up. So like personally, when I do it, I either do rum or vodka, and I do just straight clear.
Yeah, just use straight vodka or just straight white rum. Don't use dark or spiced rum because that's
it will ruin it.
Yeah.
But then you want to actually let them sit. So whatever your box says.
Or if you want your guest to die, just throw a little of this in there.
When you set up your jello shots, normally jello set it for this long.
Set for like 2 weeks, 3 hours.
Yeah, something like that. The thing you want to remember is your alcohol. Actually, so alcohol has a lower freezing point, so it takes longer for that alcohol to solidify into your jello. So if you're going to make jello shots and you're going to make a lot of them, be prepared to need a lot of fridge space so that way they can really set up.
Okay. Yeah, and it's best. I personally have friends that make jello shots quite regularly, and they say that they actually leave them overnight just to make sure that they're nice and firm, because I actually tried making them once and it did not turn out very well because I only let them cool for like 3 hours and they were still a little bit spongy.
And don't freeze them, it doesn't work.
Yeah.
It does not help the process.
Okay. No, don't do that.
Cool.
Don't do that at all.
Well, everyone, I want to thank you for coming out. It was wonderful. I know we have more people, but they already ran off so they can see Alkali destroy his liver. But yes, thank you so much. It's always a wonderful time hosting this panel every Oakcon.
Yep.
Where the hell did you buy that?
Jungle Gyms, baby.
Oh my
God. I don't think we're going to have enough vodka for that. We've only got one bottle.
Or like a container.
Actually, don't you have more in your room?
If you actually have a small container, that would actually be enough vodka for that gummy bear. Actually, you'd have vodka left over.
Wow.
Why the hell are we soaking this again? Why are we soaking this?
Probably.
That'll take like a whole day to soak through, though.
Yeah.
With as big as
that. Well, it's for the midnight panel, so.
Yeah, but it would take like almost a whole day for that to actually like soak in and be good.
Well, yeah,
it does take like 24 hours.
Oh, it's for tomorrow.
Yeah, tomorrow.
Okay, then that's a different story. We need to find a box to put it in. Is this really real?
Yes,
that is there's a challenge that
tries
to
change.
Why didn't we think of that? Because I don't have a death wish.
I believe I've seen that actually at Meijer.
Oh my God, hold on. Does anyone have a calculator?
Yeah,
I'm mad.
Oh, that thing? Did you think about that thing?
No. Okay, on your calculator, do me a favor.
Yeah.
51 times 29.
1,479.
Mm-hmm. Okay, now divide that by 20.
73.95.
This gummy bear has an, on my diet, this gummy bear has enough carbs to sustain me for how many days?
73 days.
Holy shit, take that thing away.
Just nibble the ear a little.
Like, oh my god.
So where can we get a
now, how in the hell does this have no fat in it, but it,
because
you know,
it's
only sugar.
Because it's just pure chemicals.
It's only sugar and chemicals.
Sugar
just what
and
I want, carcinogen.
It's like a few molecules away from plastic, okay?
Kind of like a little cheese.
Oh gosh. Everyone, thank you so much. It
yes.
was wonderful. I hope you all have a wonderful rest of your evening. You still got Friday, Saturday, Sunday. Enjoy Indy FurCon. If you see us around and you have any questions about alcohol mixing, things like that, feel free to stop us. Thank you.
Thank you. Last but not least, please drink responsibly.
Silver Gato Man, he bought me a coffee. Silver Gato Man, here is the song for thee. He likes to video all the panels at the cons. You should go and watch them whether they are short or long. Silver Gato Man, you video that's not a jibe. All of you go to his YouTube channel and like and subscribe.